In order to store data in a computer, we have to know the different kinds of data that are out there. You've probably heard that everything that's stored in a computer is just zeros and ones, and that's true. But it would be hard to program that way. So we group the zeros and ones together into groups that we can understand, and that makes it easier to program. The first category of data we're going to use are integral numbers. We call those int in programming. So these are counting numbers like 1, 2, and 3. You can recognize them because they don't have any decimal point. We'll also use numbers with decimal points. Those are called double in programming. Int versus double is very important. So in mathematics, 2 and 2.0 are the same thing. In computer science, they're not. They're from different categories. So you have to pay attention to that. There are two different ways to store words. One is called char and the other is called string. A char is a single character and a string is a group of characters together. To store data, you have to decide what category to use and give it a name so you can find it. So we could say, for example, int text messages received. The reason I picked int is because text messages are integral. That is, you receive 1 or 2 or 3. You don't receive 2.3 text messages. The variable name, text messages received, is in what we call camel case, because the top of it looks like the humps on a camel. The trick to camel case is that you put the words together without spaces, and you make the first letter of subsequent words start with a capital letter. That way you can read the words a little bit more easily. Now what this does is sets aside one location in memory and gives it a special name. Only one thing can be stored at this location at any time. So if you store something else there, you lose the thing that was stored there initially. That can be frustrating in programming sometimes. To put data in the computer, we use an assignment statement. With assignment statements, the left-hand side and the right-hand side are different. On the left-hand side, there's a location. On the right-hand side, there's a value. So if, for example, we said text messages received equals 4, we would take the value 4 and store it in the text messages received location. Now, this looks like math, but it isn't. And this is a place where computer science and math are really different. We could create another location by saying int phone calls equals 5. If we wanted to take the value in phone calls and put it in text messages, we would say text messages received equals phone calls. This takes the value 5 and stores it in the location text messages received. The data that was there previously is lost and we can't get it back. Once we have data stored in memory, we can manipulate it by performing mathematical operations. When you do this, you have to pay attention to int and double because they really matter. The common arithmetic operations are very similar. Plus and minus, for example, mean addition and subtraction. Asterisk means multiplication, so that's a little bit different. The other thing that's different is you always have to use asterisk. So you've probably seen in your algebra classes things like 3 times x, which you write 3x. But you can't do that in programming. You have to say 3 asterisk x. This is an example of the computer being very literal. There is a twist on this, however. The data type matters. When you add together 2 integral values, you get an integral value. When you add together 2 doubles, you get a double. You actually knew that from your arithmetic, because you know if you add 2 things that have fractional parts, that you're probably going to get something with a fractional part. You can add an int to a double, too. What happens is the int gets promoted to a double, and then it's added as if they were 2 doubles, so you end up with something that has a decimal point in it. There are other things that we can do in programming, too. We can interact with users, we can read in data from the keyboard, we can write out data to the screen, and when we put this all together, we'll be able to write simple programs. Start reading and doing interactive exercises to learn more.